In this video, we're going to look at field validation using a client script. So let's get started. From the home page, go to Setup. And under Setup, down under Developer Space is Client Script. We're going to create a new script. We'll just call this one Field Validation. And under the page, we're going to do the Create Page module. Today, we're going to be looking at our Proposals module. And we're going to use the new layout. And this is going to be a page event, and it's going to be on save. We want to basically look at this field, and when we go to save it, if it doesn't have the necessary selections made, then we will give an error message and pause it from being able to save. And so we're going to create a variable first, and let's just call it apps selected 0 is from the page, and the function we're going to use is get field. As you can see, as I'm typing, it starts to give suggestions, which is great and makes it easy. So the field that we need to find, if I come over to settings and came under API names into the proposals module, and I'm looking for this field here, Zoho apps included, is the multi-select field that we want to validate in this script. I'm going to paste that there. Next, I'm going to say selected. Now, let's just do equals app selected, and we want to get value. So in this, with a multi-select, it basically puts it into a list. And so if you have multiple options in that list, each one's going to have its own index, each value. And so the very first index is always zero. And so what we're going to do is we're going to look to see if that lead, or if that selected, and we're going to look at its index of one. So we want to see that it's the second in the list. Basically, we want to see if there's something there. And in prior testing and looking at these, I have found that if it is not there, it comes up, it will display as undefined. And so I'm going to look to see if that's undefined. If it's equal to undefined, then we want to show the error message. And so app selected, we're going to show error. And in here, we'll put our error message that we want to display. So I'm just going to say this needs at least two options selected. And then to prevent it from actually saving, we're going to return false. We'll save it and we'll go test it out. Now, one of the things I like to do, and I showed you in another video about client scripts, is I like to have the messages up here. So in case an error happens, I can see, or if I want to put debugging statements in there, the log statements to help see what's being produced, then you will see that here. So we're going to go test name. These, and anything that has a red on it is a required field. And so That's why I'm selecting all of these. Here is the field that we're actually looking for. And I'm just going to do select one, CRM. So when I go to save, I should get a message pops up here. And then we have to enter in a second selection. Then we go to save. And you can see it successfully saved. So that is how you create field validation with a multi-select. Other fields that you could use for this, any field you want to, if you know what it's supposed to show or not show, this is an easy way to do it, right? But these are the two important ones right here. This is your error message, and then this keeps it from being able to save. And that is how we do field validation using client scripts.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.